Welcome to Let's Play Forza Motorsport 4 Part 85, and in this segment I'm going to be driving the 1988 BMW M5. E28, okay, cool. Whoops, that's the wrong button. So, that's our car choice. Now, let's upgrade this bitch to A-Class. Because we're still doing A-Class racing. There's a lot of A-Class events in the European manufacturer thing. So, here we go. Here's the parts list. Bunch of race spec upgrades. Fine with me. Alright. So here we go. And I'll just keep it at what it's current PI. Fuck it. Just fuck it, man. Anyways, it's time for the BMW production showcase. Limited to production BMWs, of course. And Rossi leading the field in the M3 GTR. Fucking unicorns. So, here's our four venues. Three railroad tracks. And we're going to start at the Hockenheim Grand Prix circuit. Hey, T-Belch. Okay, here we go. Hockenheim Ring. Two laps. But it's not the old Hockenheim Ring, therefore it sucks. Shut up. Let's just get my classic Bimmer. Well, kind of classic. I mean, the 80s are pretty much classic now. God. It's scary to think about. Okay, let's not go four wide into this turn. Instead, we went three wide, and it was very awful. Oh, hi. How you doing, Evans? Just beat the crap out of your car. Don't mind me. Hey, Otter. Okay. Quite a bit of damage. Got some left front brake damage, so I need to prepare for possible car pulling to, I think, the right when I go on the brakes. Pulling ever so slightly to the right. And I was early on the brakes, and I'm now getting bullied by Rossi and Esposito. So that's wonderful. Careful, careful. Come on, get around Rossi and his unicorn. Moore's trying to get away. Should probably, make quick work at Evans here so Moore doesn't get away. There we go. I really like this car. I don't know what it is with like the late 80s, early 90s BMWs, but they look really nice. I don't know why. I guess I just like this style.
I'm a 90s kid.
I was born in the late wrong generation, except I was actually a 90s kid, because I was born in 91. What the fuck am I saying? Alright, Moore. On guard. My classic E28? Yeah, E28. Or whatever power will defeat you. Well, highly upgraded E28 power, but you know. Still out of power disadvantage. Oh well, that's fine. Actually, made it nicely around that hairpin for once. That's fucking never happened. Never, ever, forever, never. Me. Go around the outside. Just barely making it into the turn and taking the lead. Nice. That was very nice. Oh shit. kind of miss the Apex. That sounds like fun, JC. Better get to money grinding then if you want to show off all the trucks in 4x4 Evo. Money grinding is fun, no it isn't. You know what is fun? Winning races, because I just did that. Yeah! It was an E28, okay. Take that more in your E60, my E28 is superior. Fucker, I don't know. Saints, one down, three to go. Bone was definitely going to reach level 12 affinity, but Alright, so, race two. Nürburgring short Grand Prix circuit. This is attempt two. Not because this race is hard or anything. In fact, this is a pretty damn easy race. Something happened. So I was cruising to victory on the final lap with my little box here. As I somehow once again take the lead without any contact whatsoever. I don't know how the fuck. Like, how do you make it through Nürburgring turn one twice in a row without touching anything? Anyways, this little curb right here, I kind of hit it a little too... I guess I was a little too aggressive on it, and I flipped the car. I flipped the car. So, yeah, that clip coming to a fail race video near you, hopefully. Because, that sure did happen. Actually, I have to remember to, like, clip that and submit it to fail race. Oh boy. That was a wonderful, wonderful flip. Best part was my car got stuck on its side and just kind of scooted along the road on its side and I couldn't do anything about it. I could not flip back over at all. That was cool. Anyways, yeah, like I said, this race, not difficult. Definitely exercising caution around that turn, trying to not touch the curb. I'd rather not roll this car again. Actually, I think I'm dominating this race more this time than I was last time. Our last attempt. That's cool. These guys can just kind of duke it out with themselves, although Rossi is comfortably in second. Yeah, I am dominating more because I didn't actually go off into, like, the sticky grass there at the chicane. Forgot that that happened until just now. So, that just leaves one lap to go here. Then da 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 da. The nutter butter, anyways. 6.6 ahead of Rossi, no big deal. Fucking Esposito. He just keeps showing up in the top four. Bastard. What a bastard. Oop, 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 oop. little too far down to the inside. Let's see, fanboy. Good luck on that surgery. With these older small BMWs and them handling so goddamn well, these small boxes. They sure can go around these damn corners quick. I mean, I know this thing's heavily upgraded because A-class, but still. Feels great, man. Feels great. So, a very, very dominant victory for me. What is the final margin of victory? Almost 10 seconds. 9.897, looks like. Very nice. Alright, well, let's move on to race 3 and hopefully not roll the car again. And stuff. Okay, race 3, we are at the Mugello Club Circuit. Guessing 3 laps is this race? 4 laps, okay. So here we go. I have a long run to turn 1, so I'll probably end up taking the lead long before we start turning. Or at least be alongside Rossi before we get to the braking point zone. Right about there. And immediately into P1. So yeah. Maybe I should have downgraded this thing just a little bit. Oh well. It's such a fun car to drive, I almost don't care. Almost. Careful of those curves. Remember what happened at Nürburgring. Ever see a clip in Ford Racing 2, which an AI went barrel rolling from you? No, I haven't seen that. Sounds like a grand old time. So I have a 2-second lead after 1 lap. This car be OP, yo. Be quite OP. Oh, shnikes. Only gained 1 second that lap. I just noticed the exhaust tips on this thing are just barely off center. Like they're just a little bit to the right of center. How's your OCD, fuckers? Anyways.
Not perfect, oh my god.
Okay, carrying too much speed. Go the slump stick to a upshift. Mm-hmm. like, look at this awesome view. Oh, got an upshift. Never mind. Fuck the awesome view. CERN. There we go, slight slide out. And there we go. I win! And once again in very convincing fashion. 6 seconds over Aussie. Hooray. Evans all the way down to 8th, Jesus. Russo finished 5th. Man, what a race in the second half of the field. Alright, one more race to go in my E28 dominance, so let's go to wherever the hell that was. Alright, here we go. Fourth and final race at Iberian Circuit for the full circuit. For 4 laps, so here we go. Thought I was dominating the last couple races, you ain't seen nothing yet. It's time for the Iberian Circuit. Although we'll actually have to make some overtakes here, since the run-up to turn 1 is A, narrow, and B, a lot shorter than Mugello and Nürburgring. Although, the run-up to turn 1 in Nürburgring is a little... not very long, because of the fucking weird-ass placement of the finish line. Just sneak around more. Follow my lead and sneak around. Hello, Rossi. Drag race time. Rossi almost plowing into me. Jesus. Let's try and get that side draft, yo. Well, I fucked up. No mechanical damage from that somehow. I'll take it. I don't know how the fuck, but I'll take it. Weird. Thought about sneaking up the inside there, but not quite. Zero crash. Okay, break earlier this time. There we go. Ugh. Rossi, why are you so slow? Trying to make a clean pass here, and he's just not having any. There we go. Round the outside like a badass. How about that? To go. Ooh, this top three breakaway here. God damn it. Broke too late again. Whoopsie. And a fly. It's very high across the sky. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't remember ever flipping anything in Ford Racing 2. Apparently you can, or at least the AI can, from that clip you showed me, son of a bitch. Let's fuck up the final turn, because why not? Oh well, I had a large enough lead where it didn't matter at all. Is that gonna force the thing to drive into the pit lane? Oh! Almost. Almost got him to drive in the pit lane. So very close, so well. But hey, I won the race. Just over 4 minutes. There we go. So, that'll conclude that. Ooh, I got some very light suspension damage somewhere. And there's that affinity level up. Just barely got it. But we got it. So, there's the BMW production showcase complete. All four races, so that'll do it for this segment. Stay tuned for more Forza, and look out for that flip at Nürburgring coming to fail race, hopefully. Please?